I want to, my name is Scott Baker. I'm the superintendent here in Spotsylvania County, and my role, my brief role this morning is to bring you a welcome and a greeting on behalf of our school division and the folks that have worked very hard to put together today's spelling bee. And of course, it is a makeup day, so I thank you all for working with the schedule and being able to make it on a very important day for you and your family. I want to start out, I'm going to introduce the mistress of ceremonies in just a second, who will make some other introductions. But I would like to again thank all of our staff members, all of our teachers, all of our schools that helped to not only promote but to facilitate what has led up to today. So if we could just acknowledge all of the work that allows us to get to this point, if we could give all of our staff and the folks that have put together this opportunity a round of applause. Next thing, raise your hand if you ever participated in a spelling bee growing up. Or, wow, I think everybody's shy. I'm not going to make you come up and spell a word. So you're not on the spot. But I know that when we get to this stage, and it was amazing when we were standing up here, all of a sudden it got quiet. And there's always a tension when you get to this level. But I want to just say that before we start, that I view this as a celebration at the beginning, not at the end with the eventual champion of the spelling bee, but that this should be a celebration all the way throughout, because the children that have made it to this stage have already had a significant achievement, and one that you as parents, as family members, as loved ones can celebrate. So let's right now give all of our participants a celebratory thank you. And like me, I hope that not only will you celebrate in their achievement, but do not be too hard on yourself, because we will all, by the first or second round, realize that we would have already been out. We will begin to try to spell the words. We will be doing little things with our fingers. We will be saying it silently. We will be looking down and up. And we will all be like, I'd be out already. And so as it goes through the different rounds, again, we just marvel at our students. At this time, I would like to introduce our vice chair, currently of the school board, who represents the Lee Hill District, but certainly, like all of our school board members, represents all of our students here in Spotsylvania County. And she will bring greetings to you, Ms. Amanda Blaylock.
Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome. I echo Dr. Baker's comments about we're about to welcome some winners here today. And when I think of the spelling bee winners, it's unlike luck of the draw or you won a door prize. These are winners that have earned a spot as the best speller in their elementary or their middle school. So that is a huge deal. So let's give them a round of applause for their hard work to get here today. And as we anticipate our winners coming out very soon that will be sitting in the chairs in front of us, if you'll bear with me, I would like to welcome some people, introduce some people to you, and share with you the format that we'll be going through today. First of all, if there's anyone from the Freelance Star who does sponsor this event, would you please stand and be recognized today? And we want to thank the Freelance Star for their support in the Spotsylvania County School Spelling Bee. We also want to thank Dr. Baker, our superintendent of schools, for bringing greetings and being here today to watch our winners as they participate on the next level. I want to introduce Mr. Wolf. You'll see him to my far left. He will serve as our online dictionary consultant today. I would like to introduce Mr. Michael Mudd to my right, who is serving as a judge. These are all central office personnel, our directors and executive directors right under Dr. Baker, and they work on his cabinet. I would also like to introduce Mary Lee Grubb, a judge today. I would also like to introduce Catherine Letillier, who I have to say has the best voice I have ever heard as our pronouncer. If you've never heard her speak, just speaking from her is a treat. Someone very important we need to have stand is Laurie Gallup, and the reason she's very important is that as we move through our process today, if you could remain standing, as we move through our process, if you have a protest, this is who you will be taking those protests to. Also, Ms. Gallup has the forms with her, is that correct? Okay. So that's who you're going to go to if there is a protest, as the speller you're here to represent is spelling. Could I also introduce Stephanie Fellinger and Shauna Ashton, who is with the winners. Miss Ashton, if you could make sure you make yourself known. There are several times I will mention that the children will need to be going with Miss Ashton, so you know where the children will be going. I would also like to introduce Miss Jennifer Baleko for her hard work in helping us coordinate this. Mr. Michael Brown, sitting in the back, who has also helped and works up here at Central Office with us as well. And Miss Kristen Weidel, if you could stand, she is going to be our recorder today. As you see, we have very capable people in all of the big positions up here ready to go and start our spelling bee. If you will bear with me, it's very important we go over the rules. I will read the rules to you now. I will read the rules to you when we have 10 spellers remaining, and then once again when 3 or fewer are remaining. The spelling bee will be conducted orally in rounds. Each speller remaining in the spelling bee at the start of a round spells one word in the round. Spellers who do not spell a word correctly will move off stage and take a seat with Miss Ashton. When 10 or fewer spellers are left at the end of the round, spellers will return to their original seat until the end of the round. At that time, the eliminated speller will move to the seat with Miss Ashton. Once a speller has started to spell a word, he or she may stop and start over, retracing the spelling from the beginning. In retracing, however, there can be no change of the letters to the sequence from first pronounced. If there are any changes in the letters or the sequence in the respelling, the speller will be eliminated. Spellers are not asked to spell a word another speller has misspelled. If all spellers in a round misspell, all remain in the competition and a new round begins. All spellers eliminated in the same round are tied for the same place. After the champion has been determined, a tiebreaker will be used, if necessary, to determine a first and second place runner-up so that we can be sure to have two representatives in the Freelance Star B. The tiebreaker will be conducted using the same format as determining the champion. If only one speller in a round spells correctly, a new one-word round begins and the speller is given an opportunity to spell the next word on the list. If the speller succeeds in correctly spelling the anticipated championship word in this one-word round, the speller is declared the champion. If a speller misspells the anticipated championship word in a one-word round, a new round begins with all spellers who spelled correctly and incorrectly in the previous round. These spellers spell in their original order. According to Scripps rules, no speller or judge will respell a misspelled word. Any questions relating to a spelling of a word should be referred to Ms. Gallup immediately in writing on the official protest form. Appeals may be filed in writing by a parent, a legal guardian, or a teacher of the speller who seek reinstatement in the contest. The judges will not entertain appeals from any individual seeking to dislodge another speller from the competition. The deadline for filing an appeal is before the speller affected would have received his or her next word had he or she stayed in the competition. No appeal will be entertained after the word has been given to another speller. When 5 or fewer spellers remain, an oral appeal must be made, that is, before the speller affected would have received his or her next word had she stayed in the competition. Again, I'll be rereading those rules a couple of times as we move throughout our competition today. Before I move on to the housekeeping rules and turn this over to Ms. Letillier to begin our process, I have some special guests that are very special to me in the audience that are my colleagues on the school board that are here to watch the competition. So could you stand and be recognized as I mention your name? I see on the front row I have Ms. Dawn Shelley from the Spotsylvania County School Board, Mr. Baron Braswell in the audience as well, and Mr. Bill Blaine, if we could recognize them. I believe that's all the colleagues on the school board that I saw, but if anyone else is here, please stand at this time. And welcome to you all. welcome spellers as they're walking in the room. We're just about to go over the housekeeping rules, and you are going to have a chance to introduce yourself as well. I ask everyone in the audience to please be very respectful and use a decorum worthy of their hard work and their studies to get to this day. Please turn off all of your cell phones. As you can imagine, silence is of the utmost importance in this type of competition. We want to make sure all of our spellers have complete silence so they are not distracted with their thinking or their spelling, and they can hear the words appropriately. They will have a chance to ask their questions back to our pronouncer, and we want to make sure that she can hear them as well. If there is disruption, I will stop the spelling bee until the disruption has stopped, and then we will restart. Please be mindful. They have worked very hard, and we want to give them our utmost respect, professionalism, and silence as they try to spell their words. And as Dr. Baker mentioned, it's a very impressive competition because I think I would be out after the first round. At this time, I would like to turn it over to Ms. Catherine Letelier to begin the spelling bee.
Good morning and welcome. And welcome, spellers, and congratulations on participating in the 2017 Division Spelling Bee. We're going to start the first round with each of you coming up in your numerical order and spelling your name. Introduce yourself. You can tell us the school you come from and then spell your name. Make sure when you do so that you adjust the microphone so that it suits you and that we can hear you, okay? When one person is up at the microphone, the next person in line should be in queue, should stand up and line up behind them so that we just keep on going. Thank you very much and congratulations. Speller number one. You can use either microphone.
My name is Mallory Taylor. I am from Chancellor Elementary, and I'm a third grader. M-A-L-L-O-R-Y.
I'm Rada Decker from Chancellor Middle School, R-A-D-H-A.
My name is Emily Kilmartin. I'm from Battlefield Elementary School, E-M-I-L-Y.
My name is Brooke Arena. I'm from Nye River Middle School, and I'm in sixth grade, B-R-O-O-K-E.
My name is Sabrina Alexander. I'm from Rock Road Elementary School, S-A-B-R-I-N-A.
My name is Brianna Carter. I'm from Berkeley Elementary School. I'm in fifth grade, B-R-I-A-N-A.
My name is Min, and I'm from Post Oak Middle, M-I-N.
My name is Elizabeth. I'm from Smith Station Elementary, E-L-I-Z-A-B-E-T-H.
My name is Kelly Ross. I am from Courthouse Road Elementary, K-E-L-L-Y.
My name is Bradley. I am from Smith Station Elementary School, and I am in fourth grade, B-R-A-D-L-E-Y.
My name is Tyler Bergwald, and I am from Robert E. Lee Elementary School. I'm in fifth grade, T-Y-L-E-R.
This is Haley Whittier. I'm from Nye River Middle School, and I'm in seventh grade, H-A-I-L-E-Y.
My name is Autumn Wright, A-U-T-U-M-N. I'm in fifth grade. I'm from Courthouse Road Elementary.
My name is Ben Wisman, and I am from Riverview Elementary School. I am in third grade, B-E-N.
My name is Gabriella Henderson. I'm from Wilderness Elementary School. I'm in fifth grade. G-A-B-R-I-E-L-L-A.
My name is Molly Schnellenberger. I'm from Harrison Road Elementary. I'm in fifth grade. M-O-L-L-Y.
I am Rachel Reed. I'm from Harrison Road Elementary, and I'm in fifth grade. R-I-C-H-A-E-L.
I'm Mona Milani, and I'm from Parkside Elementary School, and I'm in fifth grade. M-O-N-A.
My name is Yash Patel. I'm from Spotsylvania. I'm a seventh grader at Spotsylvania Middle School. Y-A-S-H.
My name is Olivia Caesar, and I'm from Lee Hill Elementary. O-L-I-V-I-A.
My name is Jonathan Pendergraft. I'm from, I'm a seventh grader at Freedom Middle School. J-O-N-A-T-H-A-N.
My name is Adam Korn. I'm from Wilderness Elementary, and I'm in fifth grade, A-D-A-M.
My name is Christina Vasquez, and I'm from Spotswood Elementary School. I'm in fifth grade, C-R-I-S-T-I-N-A.
My name is Lexi Morkowski, and I am from Berkeley Elementary School. I am in fourth grade, L-E-X-I.
My name is Tyler Mosier, and I'm from Robert E. Lee Elementary. I'm in fourth grade, T-Y-L-E-R.
Mm-hmm. My name's Kieran Garner, and I'm from Livingston Elementary, and I'm in fifth grade, K-I-E-R-D-A-N.
I'm Alex, and I'm from Salem Elementary, and I'm in third grade. A-L-E-X.
My name is Bethany McLeod. I am in third grade from Livingston Elementary School. B-E-T-H-A-N-Y.
My name is Yuan Bijuti. I'm from Battlefield Middle School, and I'm in sixth grade. J-U-A-N.
My name is Anaya. I'm from third grade. My school is Chancellor Elementary, I-N-A-A-Y-A.
My name is Daniel.
Hello.
Well, that worked. My name is Daniel. I am a seventh grader from Freedom Middle School, D-A-N-I-E-L.
My name is Adriana Patton. I'm an eighth grader at Battlefield Middle School, A-D-R-I-A-N-A.
My name is Samantha Ho. I'm a fifth grade from Cedar Forest, S-A-M-A-N-T-H-A.
My name is Natalie Pronk from Battlefield Elementary School. I'm in fourth grade, N-A-T-A-L-I-E.
My name is Hannah Alexander. I'm from Brock Road Elementary School, and I'm in fifth grade, H-A-N-N-A-H.
My name is Amanda Jones. I'm from Riverview Elementary School. I'm in fifth grade, A-M-A-N-D-A.
My name is Peyton Patterson. I'm from Thordberg Middle School, and I'm in sixth grade, P-A-Y-T-O-N.
My name is Taylor Gray. I'm in eighth grade at Post Oak Middle School, T-A-Y-L-O-R.
My name is Kelsey Grover. I'm from Spotswood Elementary, and I'm in fourth grade, K-E-L-S-E-Y.
My name is Baylor Gallagher. I'm an eighth grader at Chancellor Middle School, B-A-Y-L-O-R.
My name is Yasin Shahada, and I'm from Cortland Elementary School, Y-A-S-I-N.
My name is Anshu Pathak, A-N-S-H-U. I am a seventh grader from Spotsy Middle.
My name is Aiden, and I'm from Lee Hill School, Elementary School, and I'm from fourth grade, A-I-D-E-N.
I'm Fred Klein. I'm a fourth grader at Cortland Elementary School, F-R-E-D.
And that concludes round one. Before we continue round two, we'd like to do two things. First, we'd like to recognize the principals and advisors from each of the elementary and middle schools who have helped these students. And if you would please stand if you are here. Thank you for all of your hard work. We'd also at this time like to invite parents to come forward and take pictures of your children in their seats. If you'd like to, please come on down before we begin round two. And we will now proceed with round two. Congratulations again to all the spellers for making it to the Division Spelling Bee. Will speller number one come up? The word is emperor.
Emperor. E-M-P-E-R-R-O-R.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is zodiac.
Zodiac. Z-O-D-I-A-C.
That is correct. The word is prosthetic.
Can I have a language of origin, please?
The word is from the Greek.
Can you please repeat it?
Prosthetic.
P-R-E-S-T-H-E-T-I-C. Prosthetic.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is nonviolent.
Nonviolent. N-O-N-V-I-O-L-E-N-T.
That is correct. The word is artillery.
Artillery. A-R-T-I-L-E-R-Y. Artillery.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is treatise.
Treatise. T-R-E-A-T-I-S-E. Treatise.
That is correct. The word is antidote.
Antidote. A-N-T-I-D-O-T-E. Antidote.
That is correct. The word is servitude.
May I have the language of origin?
This word went from Latin to French to English.
Can I have a definition?
The condition of subjecting to slavery or something like slavery.
Servitude. S-E-R-V-I-T-U-D-E. Servitude.
That is correct. The word is derelict.
Derelict. D-A-R-A-L-I-C-T. Derelict.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is charismatic.
Please have a language of origin.
This word is from the Greek.
Please have a new sentence.
Mr. Brown's charismatic teaching style inspired his students to put in extra effort on their assignments.
Charismatic. C-H-A-R-I-S-M-A-T-I-C. Charismatic.
Please stand by. That is correct. The word is tremendous.
Can you please use it in a sentence?
Wendy raved that her months of spelling bee preparation had left her with a tremendous vocabulary.
Tremendous. T-R-E-M-E-N-D-O-U-S. Tremendous.
That is correct. The word is laburnums.
Laburnums. L-A-B-U-R-N-U-M-S. Laburnums.
That is correct. The word is venerable.
Venerable. V-E-N-E-R-A-B-L-E.
That is correct. The word is antiquated.
Antiquated. A-N-T-I-Q. A-U-T-E-D.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is resonate.
Resonate. R-E-S-I-N-A-T-E. Resonate.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is pearlescent.
Pearlescent. P-E-A-R-L. E-S-C-E-N-T, pearlescent.
That is correct. The word is stratagems.
Can you please repeat?
Stratagems.
Stratagems. S-T-R-A-T-G-E-M-S. Stratagems.
That is incorrect. The word is petrifying.
Petrifying. P-E-T-R-I-F-Y-I-N-G. Petrifying.
That is correct. The word is boulevards.
Boulevards. B-O-U-L-E-V-A-R-D-S. Boulevards.
That is correct. The word is enumerated.
Enumerated. E-N-U-M-E-R-A-T-E-D. Enumerated.
That is correct. The word is hovel.
Hovel. H-O-V-E-L. Hovel.
Correct. This word could be confused with a similar word, collision. It is a noun, the action or an instance of two or more things striking forcefully together, typically by accident. Collision.
Collision. C. O L L I S I O N, collision.
That is correct. The word is marvelous.
Marvelous. M A R V E L O U S, marvelous.
That is correct. This word could be confused with a similar word, bedlam. It is a noun, a place or scene of wild, mad uproar. Bedlam.
Bedlam. B-E-D-L-U-M. Bedlam.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. This word has a near homonym, Mandarin. It is a noun, the main dialect of Chinese spoken in China. Mandarin.
Mandarin. M-A-N-D-A-R-I-N. Mandarin.
That is correct. The word is prodigious.
Can you use that in a sentence?
The mayor complimented the public works crews for their prodigious efforts in coping with this year's heavy snowfalls.
Prodigious. P-R-O-D-I-G-O-U-S. Prodigious.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is alpinist.
A-L. I-N-E-S-S.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. This word could be confused with a similar word, uranium. It is a noun, a silvery, heavy, radioactive, metallic element that is used primarily in atomic energy programs. Uranium.
Uranium. U-R-A-N-Y-U-M.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is affectionately.
Affectionately. A F F E C T I O N A T E L Y. Affectionately.
That is correct. This word has a near homonym, sanctum sanctorum. It is a noun, a study, office, or place of retreat where one is free from intrusion.
Sanctum sanctorum. S-A-N-C-T-U-M-S-A-N-C-T-O-R-U-M.
That is correct. The word is quandary.
Quandary. Q-U-A-N-D-A-R-Y.
That is correct. The word is assailant.
Assailant. A-S-S-A-I-L-A-N-T. Assailant.
Correct. The word is gladiatorial.
Gladiatorial. G-L-A-D-I-A-T-O-R-I-A-L. Gladiatorial.
Correct. The word is undulating.
Undulating. And G I L A T I N G.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. The word is aperture.
Aperture. A P P R I T U R E.
I'm sorry, it's incorrect. The word is functionary.
Functionary. F U N C T I O N A R Y. Functionary.
Correct. This word could be confused with a similar word, hypotenuse. It is a noun, the side of a right-angled triangle that is opposite the right angle. Hypotenuse.
Hypotenuse. H-Y-P-O-T-E-N-U-S-E.
Correct. The word is exquisite.
Exquisite. E-X-Q-U-I-S-I-T-E. Exquisite.
Correct. The word is tremulous.
Tremulous. T-R-E-M-U. L-O-U-S, tremulous.
Correct. The word is Holocaust.
Holocaust. H-O-L-O-C-A-U-S-T. Holocaust.
Correct. The word is inadvertent.
Inadvertent. I-N-A-D-V-E-R-T-A-N-T. Inadvertent.
Sorry, that is incorrect. Mm-hmm. The word is Einstein.
Einstein. E-I-N-S-T-E-I-N.
Correct.
The word is nuisance.
Nuisance. N-U-I-S-A-N-C-E.
Correct. The word is vagabonds.
Vagabonds. V-A-G-A-B-O-N-D-S. Vagabonds.
Correct. That concludes round two. And we're beginning round three. This word could be confused with a similar word, machete. It is a noun, a large heavy knife usually made with a blade, often 2 or 3 feet in length. Machete.
Machete. M-A-C-H-E-T-E.
That is correct. The word is patronymic.
Patronymic. P-A-T-R-O-N-Y-M-I-C.
Correct. The word is tetanus.
Tetanus. T-E-T-A-N-U-S.
Correct. This word could be confused with a similar word, remonstrance. It is a noun, an act or instance of saying or pleading in protest or opposition. Remonstrance.
Remonstrance. R-E-M-O-N-S-T-R-A-N-C-E. Remonstrance.
That is correct. This word has a homonym, ascetic. It is an adjective, self-denying, austere. Ascetic.
Ascetic. A-S-C-E-T-I-C. Ascetic.
Correct. The word is syncope.
Please have the definition.
Loss of consciousness resulting from arrest of the blood supply to the brain. A faint.
Hey, please repeat the word.
Syncope.
Syncope?
Syncope.
Is there any alternative pronunciation?
Syncope.
Syncope. S Y N C-O-P-Y, syncope.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is churlish.
Can you please use it in a sentence?
Mr. Shuckman tolerated no churlish behavior in his classroom.
Churlish. C-H-U-R-L-E-S-H. Churlish.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is pirouetted.
Pirouetted. P-I-R-O-U-E-T-T-E-D. Pirouetted.
Correct. The word is Cotswold.
Cotswold.
C-O-T-S-W-O-L-D.
That is correct. This word could be confused with a similar word, toccata. It is a noun, a brilliant musical composition, usually for pipe organ or harpsichord, in free fantasia style, and usually with many equal-timed notes in rapid movement. Toccata.
Toccata. T-O-C-A-T-T-A. Toccata.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is promulgate.
Promulgate. P-R-O-M-U-L-G-A-T-E. Promulgate.
Correct. This word has a homonym, walla. It is a noun, a person who is associated with a particular type of work or who performs a specific duty or service, walla.
W-A-L-L-A-H.
That is correct. The word is aspidistra.
Aspidistra. A-S-P-I-D-I-S-T-R-A. Aspidistra.
Correct. The word is Cayenne.
Would you please state the language of origin?
This word is from a French Guiana geographical name that was formed from a Tupi word.
Is there an alternate pronunciation?
Cayenne.
Cayenne. C-A-Y-A-N. Cayenne.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is decrepitude.
Can you please repeat that?
Decrepitude.
You state it in a sentence.
Once inside, Gideon was shocked at the decrepitude of the old house.
Decrepitude. D-E-C-R-E-P-I-T-U-D-E.
Correct. The word is pterodactyl.
Pterodactyl. T E R A D A C T L E, pterodactyl.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is recherche.
Recherche. Can you repeat the word, please?
Recherche.
R-U-S-A-I-R-S-H-E.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is crustaceans.
Crustaceans. C R E S T A C I A N S, crustaceans.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is au fait.
Au fait. A U space F A I T.
Correct. The word is gendarme.
Gendarme. G E N D A R M E.
That is incorrect. This word has a homonym, mandrill. It is a noun, a large, fierce baboon of Western Africa with a male having blue ridges on each side of the red-bridged nose. Mandrill.
Mandrill. M-A-N-D-R-I-L-L.
That is correct. The word is supererogation.
Supererogation. S-U-P-E-R-E-R-O-G-A-T-I-O-N. Supererogation.
Correct. The word is reveille.
Can you please repeat that?
Reveille.
Reveille. R-E-V-O-L-E-E, reveille?
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is Huguenot.
H-U-G-U-E-N-O-T.
Correct. The word is trek.
Can you please use it in a sentence?
The hike to the area known as the Chimney Tops turned out to be quite a trek.
Trek. T-R-E-K, trek.
Correct. The word is waltz.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
When the band started playing the waltz, Marilyn hoped that someone would ask her to dance.
Waltz. W-A-L-T-Z. Waltz.
Correct. The word is diary.
Diary. May I please have a definition?
A book intended or used for a daily record of personal activities, reflections, or feelings.
Diary. D-I-A-R-Y. Diary.
Correct. This word has a homonym. Croon. It's a verb. Sing in half voice, especially into a closely held microphone. Croon.
Could I please have the definition?
Sing in half voice, especially into a closely held microphone.
Croon. C-R-U-N-E.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is tornado.
Tornado. T-O-R-N-A-D-O.
Correct. The word is daily.
Daily. D-A-I-L-Y. Daily.
Correct. That concludes round three. The spelling bee will resume in just a few minutes. We ask you to bear with us while we listen back to a recording. We are ready to begin round four. Spellers, please make sure you enunciate your letters all the way through to the end of the word to make sure that we are judging you absolutely accurately. Thank you. The word is monsoon.
Monsoon. M-O-N-S-O-O-N.
Correct. The word is loiter.
Can I have the definition?
Remain in or near a place in an idle or apparently idle manner. Hang around aimlessly or as if aimlessly. Loiter.
Loiter. L-O-I-T-E-R.
Correct. The word is muskrat.
Definition?
an abundant aquatic rodent found throughout the United States and Canada, living in holes in the banks of ponds or streams, or in home-shaped houses of rushes and mud. Muskrat.
Muskrat. M-U-S-K-A-R-A-T.
Correct. The word is dogged.
Can you please repeat it?
Dogged.
Dogged. D-O-G-G-E-D. Dogged.
Correct. The word is nosiest.
Can I have a definition?
Most prying or inquisitive. Nosiest.
Can I have the language of origin?
This word consists of an originally English element plus English combining forms.
Nosiest. N-O-S-I-E-S-T. Nosiest.
That is correct. The word is mammoth.
Mammoth. M-A-M-M-O-T-H. Mammoth.
Correct. The word is womanly.
Womanly. W O M E N L Y.
Sorry, that is incorrect. The word is learned.
Can you repeat the word, please?
Learned.
Learned. L-E-R-N-E-D. Learned.
That is incorrect. The word is Netherlander.
Netherlander. N-E-T-H-E-R-L-A-N-D-E-R. Netherlander.
Correct. The word is aspen.
Aspen. A-S-P-E-N.
Correct. The word is dreary.
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 Dreary. D-R-E-A-R-Y. Dreary.
Correct. The word is ballerina.
Ballerina. B A L L E R I N I A.
Sorry, that is incorrect. The word is Capricorn.
Capricorn. C-A-P-R-I-C-O-R-N. Capricorn.
That is correct. The word is fiend.
Fiend. Can I have the definition?
A person excessively devoted to or captivated by a pursuit, practice, or object of study. A fanatic. Fiend.
Fiend. F-I-E-N-D. Fiend.
Correct. The word is nostril.
N-O-S-T-R-I-L.
Correct. The word is caboose.
Caboose.
C-A-B-O-O-S-E, caboose.
Correct. The word is dearth.
Can you repeat the word, please?
Dearth.
Can you give me the definition?
Deficiency or inadequate supply of something as news, or of some quality as courage. Dearth.
D-I-R-T-H, dearth.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. This word has a homonym, confidence. It is a noun, a relation or state of trust between persons who share or impart secrets or intimate matters. Confidence.
Confidence. C-O-N-F-I-D-E-N-C-E. Confidence.
Correct. The word is sultan.
Sultan. S-U-L-T-A-N.
Correct. The word is diorama.
Diorama. D-I-O-R-A-M-A. Diorama.
Correct. That concludes round four. We begin round five. The word is falsetto.
Falsetto. F-A-L-S-E-T-T-O.
Correct. The word is geothermal.
Geothermal. G-E-O-T-H-E-R. M-A-L.
Correct. The word is crescent.
Crescent. B-R-E-S-E-N-T.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. This word has a homonym, llama. It is a noun, any of several cud-chewing mammals of South America related to the camels but smaller and without a hump. Llama.
Llama. L-L-A-M-A. Llama.
Correct. The word is gradient.
Can I have the language of origin?
This word is from the Latin.
Can I have a definition?
The inclination or the rate of regular or graded ascent or descent, as of a slope, roadway, or pipeline. Gradient.
Gradient. G-R-A-D-I-E-N-T. Gradient.
Correct. The word is mathematics.
Mathematics. M-A-T-H-E-M. A-T-I-C-S, mathematics.
Correct. The word is harmonica.
Harmonica, H-A-R-M-O-N-I-C-A, harmonica.
Correct. The word is stoic.
Stoic. S-T-O-I-C. Stoic.
Correct. The word is furlong.
Furlong. May I please have a definition?
A unit of distance equal to 1/8 statute mile.
Furlong. F-U-R-L-O-N-G. Furlong.
Correct. The word is hypothesis.
Hypothesis. H-Y-P-O-T-H-E-S-I-S. Hypothesis.
Correct. The word is ambulance.
Ambulance. A-M-B-U-L-A-N-C-E. Ambulance.
Correct. The word is contraband.
C-O-N-T-R-A-B-A-N-D.
Correct. The word is hassock.
Hassock. H-A-S-S-O-C-K. Hassock.
That's correct. The word is seersucker.
Seersucker. S-E-E-R-S-U-C-K-E-R. Seersucker.
That is correct. The word is threshold.
Threshold. T-H-R-E-S-H. O-L-D.
That is correct. The word is haversack.
Haversack. H-A-V-E-R-S-A-C-K. Haversack.
That is correct. That concludes round 5. And we begin round 6. This word could be confused with a similar word, rotunda. It's a noun, a round building, especially one that is round both outside and inside and is covered by a dome. Rotunda.
Rotunda. R-O-T-U-N-D-A.
That is correct. The word is Satori.
Can you repeat the word?
Satori.
Can I have a definition?
Sudden enlightenment and a state of consciousness attained by intuitive illumination, representing the spiritual goal of Zen Buddhism.
Satori. S-A-T-O-R-I-E.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is adamant.
Adamant. A-D-A-M-A-N-T. Adamant.
Correct. The word is scenario.
Can I have a sentence?
The prosecutor's scenario was based totally on circumstantial evidence.
Language of origin.
This word is from an originally Greek word that passed into Latin.
Scenario. S-E-N-A-R-I-O. N-E-R-I-O scenario?
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is tantalize.
Tantalize. T-A-N-T-A-L-I-Z-E. Tantalize.
Correct. The word is alleviate.
Alleviate. A-L-L-E-V-I-A-T-E.
Correct. This word could be confused with a similar word, cavalry. It's a noun, the component of an army that maneuvers and fights on horseback. Cavalry.
Cavalry. C-A-V-A-L-R-Y. Cavalry.
Correct. The word is harpsichord.
Harpsichord. H A R P S I C O R D E. Harpsichord.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is amnesia.
Amnesia. A M N E S I A. Amnesia.
Correct. The word is Kremlin.
Kremlin. Can I have the origin, please?
The word is from Russian.
Kremlin. K-R-E-M-L-I-N. Kremlin.
Correct. The word is arsenal.
A-R-S-E-N-A-L.
That is correct. The word is mongrel.
Mongrel. M-O-N-G-R-E-L. Mongrel.
Correct. The word is syntax.
Syntax. S-Y-N. T-A-X, syntax.
Correct. The word is trajectory.
May I please repeat the word?
Trajectory.
T-R-A-J-E-C-T-O-R-Y.
Correct. This word has a near homonym. Vulcanize. It's a verb, subject various materials as for hardening to a process of treating in a various ways. Vulcanize.
Vulcanize. V-U-L-C-A-N-I-Z-E. Vulcanize.
Correct. That concludes round six.
Well, if you notice, we are down to your top and final 12. Let's give them one more round of applause. At this time, I'm going to go over the rules one more time. I will be doing this once again when we reach our final three. Congratulations to you for making the top 12. The spelling bee will be conducted orally in rounds. Each speller remaining in the spelling bee at the start of the round spells one word in the round. Spellers who do not spell a word correctly will move off stage and take a seat with Mrs. Ashton. When 10 or fewer spellers are left at the end of the round, spellers will return to their original seat until the end of the round. At that time, eliminated spellers will move to the seat with Mrs. Ashton. Once a speller has started to spell a word, he or she may stop and start over, retracing the spelling from the beginning. In retracing, however, there can be no change of letters in their sequence from the first pronounced. If there are changes in the letters of their sequence in the respelling, the speller will be eliminated. Spellers are not asked to spell a word another speller has misspelled. If all spellers in a round misspell, all remain in competition and a new round begins. All spellers eliminated in the same round are tied for the same place. After the champion has been determined, a tiebreaker will be used if necessary to determine a first and second place runner-up, so we are sure to have two representatives in the Freelance Star B. The tiebreaker will be conducted using the same format determining a champion. If only one speller in the round spells correctly, a new one-word round begins and the speller is given an opportunity to spell the next word on the list. If the speller succeeds in correctly spelling the anticipated championship word in this one-word round, the speller is declared the champion. If a speller misspells the anticipated championship word in a one-word round, a new round begins with all spellers who spelled correctly and incorrectly in the previous round. These spellers spell in their original order. According to Scripps rules, no spellers or judges will respell a misspelled word. Regarding protest, any questions relating to the spelling of a word should be referred to Mrs. Gallup immediately in writing on the official protest form. Appeals may be filed in writing by a parent, legal guardian, or a teacher of the speller who is seeking reinstatement into the contest. The judges will not entertain appeals from individuals seeking to dislodge another speller from competition. The deadline for filing an appeal is before the speller affected would have received his or her word had he or she stayed in the competition. No appeal will be entertained after the word has been given to another speller. When five or fewer spellers remain, an oral appeal must be made immediately, that is, before the speller affected would have received his or her next word had he or she remained in the competition. Ms. Letelier.
We begin round seven. The word is relevant. I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is musicale.
Musicale. M-U-S-I-C-A-L-E. Musicale.
Correct.
The word is participant.
Participant. P-A-R-T-I-C-I-P-A-N-T. Participant.
Correct.
The word is imam.
Imam, I-M-A-M.
Correct.
The word is autopsy.
Autopsy, A-U-T-O-P-S-Y, autopsy.
Correct.
The word is commish.
Can you repeat the word?
Commish.
Commish. K-A-N-I-S-H. Commish.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
The word is machismo.
Machismo. M-A-C-H-I-S-M-O. Machismo.
Correct.
This word has a near homonym, Homburg. It's a noun, a man's hat of smooth finished felt with a stiff curled ribbon-bound brim and a high tapered crown creased lengthwise. Homburg.
Is there an alternate pronunciation?
Homburg.
H-O-M-B-E-R-G.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
The word is pitch blend.
Pitch blend. P-I-T-C-H-B-L-E-N-D-E. Pitch blend.
Correct. The word is howitzer.
Howitzer. H-O-W-I-T-Z-E-R. Howitzer.
Correct. This word has a near homonym, muslin. It is a noun, a plain woven cotton fabric that is used, bleached or unbleached, for sheeting, embroidery, or other purposes. Muslin.
Muslin. M-U-S-L-I-N.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
The word is antipasto.
Antipasto. A-N-T-I-P-A-S-T-O. Antipasto.
Correct. That concludes round 7. We're ready for round 8. The word is... One moment.
We're going to take a brief recess and allow the children to use the restroom. Feel free to do that yourself. There's some in the back of the facility out the door. Let's try to resume within 5 minutes. Their seats, please. We would like to resume the spelling bee.
We begin round 8. The word is nemesis.
Nemesis. N-E-M-E-S-I-S. Nemesis.
Correct.
The word is beleaguer.
Can you please give me a definition?
Subject to oppressive or grievous forces, harass.
Can you repeat the word?
Beleaguer.
B-E-L-E-G-E-R, beleaguer.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
The word is altruism.
Can you repeat the word?
Altruism.
Altruism. A-L-T-R-U-I-S-M.
Correct. The word is babka.
Can you
repeat the word?
Babka.
Can I have the definition, please?
A glazed sweet bread made with dried fruit as raisins. Babka.
Is there any alternate pronunciations?
Babka.
B-A-B-K-A?
Correct.
This word has a homonym, stollen. It is a noun, a sweet yeast bread containing fruits and nuts, usually made in a long oval loaf. Stollen.
Stollen. S-T-O-L-L-E-N. Stollen.
Correct.
The word is thesaurus.
Thesaurus. T-H-E-S-A-U-R-U-S. Thesaurus.
Correct.
The word is bureaucracy.
Bureaucracy. B-U-R-E-A-U-C-R-A-C-Y. Bureaucracy.
Correct.
The word is maladroit.
Maladroit. M-A-L-A-D-R-O-I-T. Maladroit.
Correct. That concludes round 8. We begin round 9. This word could be confused with a similar word, periphery. Noun, surrounding space, an area lying beyond the strict limits of a thing. Periphery.
Periphery. P-E-R-I-P-H-E-R-Y. Periphery.
Correct.
The word is metaphor.
Metaphor. M-E-T-A-P-H-O-R, metaphor.
Correct.
The word is precocious.
Is there any alternate pronunciations?
No.
Can I have the definition?
Manifesting at an early age some of the mental or physical characteristics usually associated with maturity. Precocious.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Van showed a precocious interest in politics by campaigning vigorously for room captain in first grade.
Precocious. P-R-E-C-A-U-T-I-O-U-S?
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
The word is camouflage.
Camouflage. C A M O U F L A G E. Camouflage.
Correct. The word is precipice.
Precipice. P-R-E-C-I-P-I-C-E, precipice.
Correct. The word is crescendo.
Crescendo. C-R-E-S-C-E-N-D-O, crescendo.
Correct. The word is perennial.
Perennial. P E R E N N I A L. Perennial.
Correct. That concludes round 9. We begin round 10. The word is entourage.
Entourage. E-N-T-O-U-R-A-G-E. Entourage.
Correct.
The word is philanthropy.
Philanthropy. P-H-I-L-A-N-T-H-R-O-P-Y. Philanthropy.
Correct.
The word is eulogy.
Eulogy. E-U-L-O-G-Y. Eulogy.
Correct.
The word is Cohen.
Could I please have the origin?
This word is from the Japanese. Koan.
Could I please have the definition?
A paradox used in Zen Buddhism as an instrument of meditation in training monks to despair of an ultimate dependence upon reason and to force them into sudden intuitive enlightenment.
Could you please repeat the word?
Koan.
Koan. K-O-A-N. Koan.
Correct.
The word is mariachi.
Mariachi. M-A-R-I-A-C-H-I. Mariachi.
That is correct.
The word is aggregate.
Aggregate. A-G-G-R-E-G-A-T-E. Aggregate.
That is correct.
That concludes round 10. We begin round 11. The word is scampi.
Scampi. S-C-A-M-P-I. Scampi.
Correct.
The word is gulag.
Gulag. G-U-L-A-G.
Correct.
The word is amenable.
Amenable. A-M-E-N-A-B-L-E. Amenable.
Correct. The word is julep.
Julep. J-U-L-E-P. Julep.
Correct. The word is phenomenon.
Phenomenon. P-H-E-N-O-M-E-N-O-N. Phenomenon.
Correct. The word is allegro.
Can I have the origin, please?
This word is from a Latin-derived Italian word.
Allegro. A-L-L-E-G-R-O, allegro.
Correct. That concludes round 11. We begin round 12. The word is kudzu.
Kudzu, K-U-D-Z-U, kudzu.
Correct. The word is provolone.
Can you repeat the word?
Provolone.
Provolone. P-R-O-V-O-L-O-N-E. Provolone.
That is correct.
The word is wampum.
Wampum. W-A-M-P-U-M. Wampum.
That is correct.
The word is pasteurize.
Pasteurize. P-A-S-T-E-U-R-I-Z-E. Pasteurize.
Correct. The word is didactic.
Didactic. D-I-D-A-C-T-I-C. Didactic.
That is correct. The word is regime.
Can I have the origin, please?
This word came from French, which formed it from a Latin word.
Can I have the definition?
The period during which a government or administration prevails.
Regime. R-E-G-I-M-E. Regime.
Correct. That concludes round 12. We begin round 13. This word has a mere homonym, cynical. It is an adjective exhibiting feelings ranging from distrustful doubt to contemptuous or mocking disbelief. Cynical.
Cynical. C-Y-N-I-C-A-L. Cynical.
Correct. The word is finesse.
Finesse. F-I-N-N-E-S-E. Finesse.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The word is cilantro.
Cilantro. C-I-L-A-N-T-R-O. Cilantro.
That is correct. This word could be confused with a similar word, kasha. It is a noun, a mush made from coarse cracked buckwheat, barley, millet, or wheat. Kasha.
Can I please have the origin?
The word is from Russian.
Kasha. K-A-S-H-A. Kasha.
Correct. The word is amicable.
Amicable. A-M-I-C-A-B-L-E. Amicable.
Correct. The word is gingham.
Can I have the origin?
This word is from Malay.
Gingham. G-I-N-G-H-A-M. Gingham.
Correct. That concludes round 13. We begin round 14. The word is egalitarian.
Egalitarian. E-G-A-L-I-T-A-R-I-A-N.
Correct. The word is angstrom.
Angstrom. A-N-G-S-T-R-O-M. Angstrom.
Correct. This word could be confused with a similar word. Flints. It's a verb. Strip as a whale or seal of blubber or skin. Flints.
Can I please have the origin?
This word is either from a Dutch word or from a Danish and Norwegian word.
Could you please repeat it?
Flints.
Is there an alternate pronunciation?
There is not.
Flens. F. L. E. N. S. E. Flens.
Correct. The word is marzipan.
Marzipan. M. A. R. Z. I. P. A. N. Marzipan.
Correct. The word is Swahili.
Swahili. S-W-A-H-I-L-I. Swahili.
Correct. That concludes round 14. We begin round 15. The word is Lederhosen.
Lederhosen. Lederhosen. Lederhosen.
Correct. The word is Waterzooi.
Waterzooi. W-A-T-E-R. Z-O-O-I, Waterzooi.
Correct. The word is Alcazar.
Alcazar. A-L-C-A-Z-A-R, Alcazar.
Correct. The word is Echt.
Can you please, what's the origin?
This word is from an originally German word.
Echt. E-C-H-T, Echt.
Correct. This word could be confused with a similar word, Meiji. It's an adjective of, relating to, or having the characteristics of the period of the reign of the Japanese Emperor Mutsuhito. Meiji.
I have a sentence.
The capital of Japan was moved from Kyoto to Tokyo during the Meiji era.
Meiji. M-A-J-I. Meiji.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
That concludes round 15. We begin round 16. The word is Einkorn.
Einkorn. E-I-N-K-O-R-N. Einkorn.
Correct. The word is Lakshan.
Lakshan. Can I have the origin?
This word is from a Yiddish word adopted from a Russian dialect word of Turkic origin.
Can you repeat it?
Lakshan.
Lakshan. L-O-K-S-H-E-N. Lakshan.
Correct. The word is arachnid.
Arachnid. A-R-A-C-H-N-I-D, arachnid.
That is correct. The word is Noviero.
Noviero. N-O-V-I-E-R-R-O, Noviero.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
That concludes round 16.
Congratulations if you're still remaining in the top three. For the last time, I will go over the rules before a champion is named. If all spellers in a round misspell, all remain in the competition and a new round begins. All spellers eliminated in the same round are tied for the same place. After the champion has been determined, a tiebreaker will be used if necessary to determine a first and second place runner-up so that we can ensure to have two representatives at the Freelance Star B. The tiebreaker will be conducted using the same format as determining the champion. If only one speller in a round spells correctly, a new one-word round begins and the speller is given an opportunity to spell the next word on the list. If the speller succeeds in correctly spelling the anticipated championship word in this one-word round, the speller is declared the champion. If a speller misspells the anticipated championship word in a one-word round, a new round begins with all spellers who spelled correctly and incorrectly in the previous round. These spellers spell in the original order. According to Scripps rules, no speller nor judge will respell a misspelled word. Any questions relating to the spelling of the word should be referred to Ms. Gallup immediately in writing in the official protest form. Appeals may be filed in writing by parent, legal guardian, teacher of the speller who is seeking reinstatement in the contest. The judges will not entertain appeals from an individual seeking to dislodge another speller from the competition. The deadline for filing an appeal is before the speller affected would have received his or her next word had he or she stayed in the competition. No appeal will be entertained after that word has been given to another speller. When five or fewer spellers remain, an oral appeal must be made immediately, that is, before the speller affected would have received his or her next word had she remained in the competition. Thank you for your attention, Ms. Letelier.
We begin round 17. This word could be confused with a similar word, charpoy. It's a noun, a bed consisting of a frame strung with tapes or light rope used especially in India. Charpoy.
Charpoy. C-H-A-R-P-O-Y. Charpoy.
That is correct.
The word is sassafras.
Sassafras. S-A-S-S-A-F-R-A-S. Sassafras.
That is correct.
The word is bromeliad.
Can I please have the origin?
This word is from a Swedish name plus a Latin combining form.
Could you please repeat the word?
Bromeliad.
Bromeliad. B-R-O-M-E-L-I-A-D. Bromeliad.
Correct.
That concludes round 17. We begin round 18. The word is Garibaldi.
Garibaldi. G-A-R-I-B-A-L-D-I.
Correct.
The word is ersatz.
Is there an alternate pronunciation?
Ersatz.
Can I have the origin?
This word is from an originally German word.
Ersatz. E-R-S-A-T-Z. Ersatz.
That is correct.
The word is Glockenspiel.
Glockenspiel. G-L-O-C-K-E-N-S-P-I-E-L, Glockenspiel.
That is correct.
That concludes round 18. We begin round 19. The word is paradigm.
have the language of origin?
This word is from Greek.
Paradigm. P-A-R-A-D-I-G-M. Paradigm.
That is correct. The word is Sauerbraten.
Sauerbraten. S-A-U-E-R-B-R-A-T-E-N. Sauerbraten.
That is correct. The word is rendezvous.
Rendezvous. R-E-N-D-E-Z-V-O-U-S. Rendezvous.
That is correct. That concludes round 19. We begin round 20. The word is Philippic.
Philippic. P-H-I-L-I-P-P-I-C. Philippic.
Correct. The word is hemerocallis.
Hemerocallis. H-E-M-E-R-O-C-A-L-L-I-S. Hemerocallis.
That is correct. The word is Fraulein.
Fraulein. F-R-A-U-L-E-I-N. Fraulein.
Correct. That concludes round 20. We begin round 21. The word is Mukhtar.
Mukhtar. M-U-K-H-T-A-R. Mukhtar.
That is correct. The word is raconteur.
Raconteur. R-A-C-O-N-T-E-U-R. Raconteur.
Correct. The word is witloaf.
Can I please have the definition?
Chicory. Also, its crown of foliage as a salad green. Witloaf.
Can I please have the origin?
This word is from a Dutch word.
Witloaf. W H I T L O A F. Witloaf.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. That concludes round 21. We begin round 22. The word is Hoʻomalemale.
Can you please repeat it?
Hoʻomalemale.
Hoʻomalemale. H-O-O-M-A-L-I-M-A-L-I. Hoʻomalemale.
That's correct. The word is Vaisnictvur.
Can I have the origin?
This word is from a German phrase that became a literary geographical name.
Can you repeat it?
Vaisnictvo.
Vaisnictvo. W-E-I-S-S-N-I-C-H-T-W-O. Vaisnictvo.
That is correct. That concludes round 22. I'm going to skip 300. We begin round 23. This word has a near homonym, laguna, noun, a shallow sound, channel, pond, or lake, near or communicating with the sea. Laguna.
May I have the origin, please?
This word went from Latin to Spanish.
Is there an alternate way to say it?
There is not.
Can you repeat it?
Laguna.
Laguna. L-A-G-U-N-A.
Correct. The word is meritorious.
Meritorious. Can I have the origin?
This word is from Latin.
Is there another way to say it?
Meritorious.
Can you repeat it?
Meritorious, meritorious.
M-A-R-A-T. A-R-I-U-S, meritorious.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
That concludes round 23. This will be the championship round. The word is platitudes.
May I have the origin, please?
This word was formed in French from a probably originally Greek part that passed through Latin and an originally Latin part.
Can you please repeat it?
Platitudes.
Platitudes. P-L-A-T-I-T-U-D-E-S. Platitudes.
That is correct. We would like to welcome our final two, congratulate them, outstanding spelling today. And the winner of the Spotsylvania County Spelling Bee, speller number 7, Min Lee. Congratulations. Yes. parents are welcome to come up for pictures. If I can invite the other school board members in the audience to join us for pictures as well. Once again, a huge congratulations to our winners. Job well done.
Thank you. You did great. You guys, congratulations.
I would have been out after the first round, I'm just telling you.